I'm going to talk about periodic signals and aperiodic signals. So an important class of signals that we will usually encounter throughout this course is the class of periodic signals. Okay, so a periodic continuous time signal x of t is said to be periodic with period capital T if and only if x of t is equal to x of t plus capital T. Okay, so a periodic continuous time signal has the property that there is a positive value, okay, positive value of t for which this condition holds for all values of small t. Okay, in other words, a periodic signal has the property that it is unchanged by time shift of capital T. If you move by a time shift of capital T, the function does not change. Okay, so in this case we say that x of t is periodic with the period capital T. Periodic continuous time signals arise in a variety of contexts. For example, a natural response of an LC circuit. Response of systems, okay, in which energy is conserved. For example, as I said, you have an inductor and capacitor, and the natural response of the circuit is a periodic signal. Okay, so it contains L and C, inductance and capacitor, without resistive energy dissipation, and also the ideal mechanical systems without frictional losses are periodic. Okay, so in fact it composes the basic periodic signals that we will study in the later part of this course. So let me show you some example. Insert pictures. This guy, done. Okay, now if you look at this figure, for every t naught second, the same shape is repeated. Okay, and this is an example of a periodic continuous time signal. Okay, from this figure, so we can readily deduce that equation, like what we said, x of t is equal to x of t plus capital T, and from this equation we readily deduce that if x of t is periodic with the period T, then x of t plus capital small m and t is also periodic with the where m is some integer. Okay, some integer. Now look at this, length is T, capital T, and from this portion, whatever you have the shape, this same shape repeated from T to 2T, again it comes down. This portion is the same as this portion, and this portion is same as this portion, and this portion is same as this portion. So it is repeated periodically. Thus x of t is also periodic with the two t 3t and 4t. Also if you look at here, suppose if I look at this as a period, in case by some argument, then what happens, whatever no repeated this portion the same portion will be repeated like this. So therefore, if a signal is periodic with the period t naught or t, then also it is periodic with 2t, 3t, 4t and so on and so forth. But this period, no, the least period, that is called a fundamental period. So that is the one we will consider. We will not consider 2t, 3t, 4t, even though the signal is periodic with 2t, 3t and 4t, but we will consider the least value. And that least value is called a fundamental period, t naught of x of t. And which is the smallest positive value of t. Okay, what is t naught? T naught is the smallest positive value of capital T. Okay, for which this equation holds. The definition of fundamental period now works except if x of t is a constant. If x of t is constant, then you cannot apply this one. Okay, there the period is undefined. So in this case, I know when x of t is a constant function like this, then in this case the period is undefined. Okay, since x of t is periodic for any choice of t, you put t equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, whatever you want you can put out. So there is no smallest positive value here. No smallest positive value here. So the period is undefined here. Okay. A signal, the next class is, now let me point out some more points in this. So the fundamental period T defines the duration of one complete cycle of x of t. If you look at this figure, this is one complete cycle. After that, the same cycle repeated here, and again the same cycle repeats. So the t is nothing but the smallest duration over which one complete cycle will be finished, and again the same cycle will be repeated. The reciprocal of this t, one over t, the reciprocal of t is called the fundamental frequency. Fundamental frequency. So the fundamental period t naught, this is t naught. The fundamental period t naught and the fundamental frequency is denoted by f naught. Both are related as follows. F naught is equal to 1 over t naught. Okay, and we know that omega naught is equal to 2 pi f naught, therefore omega naught is equal to 2 pi times 1 over t naught. So this is 2 pi over t naught. This is your fundamental frequency, that is angular frequency. Okay, now let us move on to aperiodic signal. The signal which is not periodic over any period, then you can say that signal is not periodic. Okay, so a signal x of t that is not periodic will be referred to as an aperiodic signal. Okay, periodic signals are defined analogously in discrete time domain also. So let me complete this definition. X of t is not equal to x of t plus capital T. So this is aperiodic. Now let me take one special case. Periodicity of signal of the form, let's say x1 of t plus x2 of t. Now what I will do, I will consider two signals, x1 of t and x2 of t. X1 of t is periodic with the period, let's say t suffix 1, and x2 of t is periodic with the period, let's say t suffix 2. Now as I said, if x of t is periodic with the t suffix 1, then also it is periodic with the with any integer multiple of t1, right? So 2t1 or x, let me write down here. If x1 of t is periodic with t1, then it is also periodic with any integer multiple of t1. That's what I want to trying to say here. X of t plus 2t1 or x of t plus 3t1 and so on. Therefore, it keep on goes. Therefore, x of t plus, let's say, small m times t1. So this is the condition for periodicity. Similarly, for this also I can write as x2 of t is equal to x of t plus 2t2 or x of t plus 3t2 and so on. So I can say x of t plus, let's say, n times some integer t2. This is x2 of t. So I have two signals which are periodic individually. Now the question is, what is the period if I add these two signals together? So the question is, x1 of t is periodic with period t1, x2 of t is periodic with period t2, then the question is, what is the period of x1 of t plus x2 of t? That is the question, period. Okay. So in this case, x1 of t plus x2 of t will be periodic if t1 by t2 is equal to n over m. Okay, so that is the condition. So both are integer. So it should be a ratio of two integers. So the period of x of t, let me call this signal is x of t and this signal is, you know, period of x of t, this is x of t, and the period of this x of t is, how do you find out? You take the ratio of t1 by t2, that should be equal to n by m. Or in other words, if you want to say, the periods of x of t will be the LCM of t1 and t2. So in, if you have three signals, then you find out LCM of T1, T2 and T3. So that's it. Okay. Now let us move on to discrete time signal. So, so the periodicity of discrete time signal also analogously defined the way we defined for a continuous time signal. Specifically, a discrete time signal, as I said, it is denoted by x of n, is periodic with a period, let's say, capital N. Here capital N is an integer. In continuous time domain, the t can be any value, any real number. But in the discrete case, they should be an integer. So that is a primary condition that one should remember. So n is a positive integer, okay? And if you shift x of n by capital N time units, then the signal is unchanged, okay? So it is equal to x of n. So this is the condition for periodicity in discrete time signals. If this condition doesn't hold, then you call that signal as aperiodic signal. It's not equal to x of n, then it is aperiodic. Now again, here also we can find out the fundamental period. Okay, the fundamental period is denoted by n suffix 0. as we said in the continuous time case, like if the signal is periodic with the capital N, then the signal is periodic with N plus some integer times, let's say k times of N, where k takes the integer value. It can be 1, 2, 3 and so on. Therefore, x of N plus capital N is equal to x of N, then x of N plus 2N also is equal to x of N, and so on so forth. And generally what we do, we will consider smallest positive value of N. We will not consider 2N as a period. We will not consider 2N as a period. Even though it is periodic with the period 2N, but we will always try to find out the smallest positive value. Smallest positive integer value. Okay, and that smallest positive integer value is called fundamental period. Fundamental period. How do you denote this fundamental period? As we denoted in the continuous time case, N naught. Okay, so let me consider one example for the discrete time case. Insert pictures. Then, yes. Done. Now look at this figure. Now, can you find out the period of this signal? This is N discrete values. Let's say this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on so forth. At 0, let's say this value is 1, this also 1, this is minus 1. You can take minus 0.5, 1, 1, minus 0.5 like this. So you have 2 ones and minus 1.5, again 2 ones and minus 0.5. So look at the pattern. The pattern goes like this and again repeats like this. So after this, again the pattern repeats. No, after this point. So from this point to this point, the pattern repeats. Okay. 0, 0 you have 1. 1 at 1 you have 1. At 2 you have minus 0.5. Then again at 3 you have 1. 4 at you have 1. At 5 you have minus 0.5. So therefore the pattern repeats. So what is the duration of this guy? 3 units. Okay. So this one and this one. So there are 3 units in between. Okay, between 3 and 0, the length is 3 time units. Therefore, this signal is periodic with the fundamental period N suffix 0 is equal to 3. Okay. Now let me take one more example. Let me define my, no, before that let me complete one more point, then I'll take that example. Now you consider two signals, let's say x1 of N plus x2 of N, as we did in the continuous case. Okay, let me add these two signals and call them x of N. Now this x of N is periodic if and only if, let's say the period of this guy is n1, the period of this guy is n2, then n1 by n2 is equal to n by m, that is ratio of two integers. We'll do some problems so that you'll get some better idea. Let us take only the definition. Therefore, let me call the period of period of x of n. Therefore, this n is equal to again LCM of n1 comma n2. And a periodic discrete time signal whose fundamental period this n can take only positive integer values. Okay. But if you take the continuous time case where t takes any real number, So this point you should remember. Let me take one example. Insert pictures. No, before that, let me state the problem, then I'll insert the figure. Draw. Now let me define a signal x of t, which is equal to cos t when t is less than 0 and sin t if t is greater than 0. Okay, so from trigonometry we know that cos of t plus 2 pi is again cos of t, right? Similarly, sin of t plus 2 pi is equal to sin t. So can I say these two signals are periodic? I cannot. Okay, because if you consider t greater than 0 and t less than 0 separately, consider t greater than 0 first and t less than 0 second, I mean you are considering separately. We say that x of t does not repeat itself over every interval of length 2 pi. If you consider t greater than 0 and t less than 0, the signal will not repeat repeat itself over every interval of length 2 pi. Okay, so let us see how this figure looks if I consider these two guys together. I need to plot the figure. For t greater than 0, I have cosine t like this. For t less than 0, I have cos t like this. Okay, so let us see how this function. If you look at this figure, this is not now repeated. Maybe I will insert the figure. This figure I took it from the textbook. Okay, see. So this one is cos t and this one is sin t. If you consider sin t individually, of course it is periodic. If you consider cosine t individually, it is periodic. But if you consider together, then this function is not periodic. There is a discontinuity here. So it suddenly it jumps to 0 here at this point. This point is 1 and this point is 0. There is a jump. Okay, and afterwards it is not repeating this jump. Therefore, the signal is not periodic. So every feature in the shape of the periodic signal must recur periodically. Okay, it must recur. Otherwise, you cannot say the signal is periodic. Therefore, we conclude that the signal is aperiodic signal. Okay, this signal is not periodic. Now, finally, I will take one more example and with that I will close this lecture. X of t is equal to j times e to the j times 10t. Now the question is the signal periodic or not? So the definition goes as like this: x of t plus capital T is a condition for periodic. Then x of t plus capital T is equal to j times e to the j 10 j times e to the j 10 t plus capital T. Then this is equal to j into e to the j 10 t plus e to the power of j times 10 capital T. Okay, now for periodicity, the left hand side, what I have? X of t e to the j times 10 t. So this, the left hand side is equal to the right hand side only if this guy should be equal to 1. Therefore, e to the j 10 t must be 1. Okay, now you find a suitable t value and then say that is equal to 1. Okay, from Euler's equation we know that e power j theta is equal to cos theta plus j into sin theta. So this is cos 10 t plus j into sin 10 t. And let us take t is equal to 2 pi times x, where x, you can take substitute x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 like that. Okay, So e to the j times pi times t is equal to, let's say generally e to the j times 2 pi k is equal to cos of 2 pi k plus j times sine of 2 pi k, where k takes integer value. Therefore, this is always equal to 1, right? So e to the j 10t must be equal to e to the j times 2 pi k. So 10t must be equal to 2 pi k. In order to find out the fundamental frequency, let us take k equal to 1, or else let it be as it is. T is equal to 2 pi k by 10, and this is pi k by 5, and this pi, because this t is the smallest positive integer, right? Smallest positive value. So in that case, I cannot take k can be anything bigger than 1. T is equal to pi k times 5, and where k can take 1, 2, 3 and so on and so forth. That's what the condition is here. Therefore, let me take k equal to 1. Otherwise, the t will not be a smallest positive value. So if you substitute t equal to 1, then t is equal to pi by 4. Therefore, the given signal j times e to the j 10t is periodic with the period what? Pi by 5. So maybe I'll take one more example. This example is very intuitive, okay? By looking at itself, you can say no need to apply any equation. E to the minus t times e to the jt. Now, how do you find this? Now, this part is periodic, you can find out. This is a complex exponential signal. But if this is decaying exponential signal, if you plot it, then it looks like this. Okay, even though this complex is periodic, just now we have seen e to the j 10t is periodic, right? Similarly, this guy also periodic alone. If you take this e to the j 10t is periodic, but that periodic signal is multiplied by a decaying exponential like that. So therefore, the periodic is a damped oscillations. Okay, in that case, it is not. Don't look at the equation and all. Okay, simply you can say it is not periodic. So let me take one example in the discrete time domain. With that, I'll conclude. X of n is equal to e to the j 7 pi n. The definition goes like this: X of n is equal to x of n plus capital N. So e to the j 7 pi n plus e to the j 7 pi capital N. So on the left hand side, x of n, what is x of n? E to the j 7 pi n. So left hand side is equal to right hand side if this guy must be equal to 1. Therefore, e to the j 7 pi capital N is equal to 1. We know from Euler's identity, e to the j theta is equal to cos theta plus j sin theta. And if you take e to the j 2 pi k, as we did in the previous example, this is cos 2 pi k plus j times sin 2 pi k. It is always equal to 1, provided that if k takes the value 1, 2 and so on. Therefore, e to the j 2 pi k is also 1. So equate these two. Therefore, 7 pi n is equal to 2 pi k. So pi pi will get cancelled. N is equal to 2 by 7 times k. So 2 by 7, where n can take integer values, okay? Where k can take an integer values, okay? K equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. So as we said, this n must be an integer. That's what we said, right? Okay, for a discrete time case, this n should be integer. For continuous time case, it can take any positive real value. To get an integer value, this k must be equal to 7. So I'm taking the minimum value of k. Also, k must be an integer. So here k can take any value, 1, it can take 2, it can take 3, it can take any value I can take. So what I'll do here, let me take k equal to 7. If I substitute k equal to 7, 2 by 7 times 7, 7 will get cancelled, which is 2, an integer. Therefore, the signal is periodic with the period 7. If I don't take k equal to 7, then I will get some rational number, then it is not, sorry, I will get some decimal number, and that decimal number is not an integer. So I cannot say that n is an that the given signal is a periodic signal. Therefore, the fundamental period n0 is equal to 2. Okay. So with that, let me stop, and in the next lecture we will continue the even signals and odd signals. Thank you very much.